And
okay,
so I totally watched your heckle videos from way back when, just so I can handle hecklers. My mom roasts me.
You're
all
doing
the time.
Great, by the way. Your mom heckles you?
Oh my God, does she ever?
It'd be amazing if she was like, "Hey, your mom," and you're like, "But you're my mom."
Yeah, mom. Oh my God, mom, please. So I actually watched some of your videos to try to you know, work on the heckling. But but you have like this approach where you are kind of like giving it to them in a really smart, funny way. But how are you gonna plan like a roast where you can like also?
Oh, I'm just gonna be mean. It's for Pete Rose. Okay. I can be as mean. I'll just be like, I'll just come out and be like, guys, look at his haircut. That's an adult that made that decision for 40 years.
Thank you, Vivian. Thank you so much.
Thank you very much. You were wonderful. Thank you.
Come on.
Because you can do that in VR.
Yeah, right.
Vivian, I think you've got quite the fan base over here.
Oh, you can't see me kicking my feet, but yeah, thank you.
Okay, Steve, feedback for Vivian.
I thought that was a lot of fun. I think that you do the likable, awkward thing very, very well. And I don't think you're trying to do it, which is why it works. It's authentic. It's you, which is wonderful. I think that, you know, you could use a little shot in the arm of confidence. But I think that you were, oh, now she's sad about it. I just hurt her confidence by saying that.
Oh, no, yes. I'm going to go cry now.
Yeah, but no, I think that is something you can learn. Like, that's teachable, whereas likability is not teachable. Likability is inherent or it's not there. So, you know, I think that you had something there. That was fun. I had a good time.
All right, thanks. Me too. Thank you. We'll do it again.
Yeah, well, let's let them decide.
Thank you, Steve. Lex.
Yeah, I mean, I similar to sort of what Steve said, I really loved your sort of self-deprecating approach. I thought that it played really well against Steve. As somebody who was having trouble walking earlier to practice coming out through that orb thing, really loved your gestures and how natural you made it seem. And in fact, like there was actual body language happening from the moment that you walked on stage. And that was unique and really added for me the sense that I was here with you.
Thank you, Lex.
Thank you.
Brett.
Yeah, very well-rounded, very enjoyable. I was smiling the whole time, I felt like. I think, kind of on Steve's point, because of the way you are playing yourself and doing it so well and so naturally, I think it actually was a good idea the way you brought up how you found information about him. You looked at his Twitter. You know, like in a real talk show, you'd have segment producers doing all this research, but you kind of admitted to the fact that that's how you found the material and to ask him about. And that got, I think, the most unique content out of him because you kind of knew things that he would have things to talk about. So I really commend how you did it and the way you kind of just brought it up naturally and reminded us that you're just kind of sitting at home, you know, all of a sudden hosting a talk show in front of all these people. And the only way you can do this is in VR. So I thought you did a really good job.
I didn't know it was going down like this either. So yeah. Never.
How'd you think it was going to go down?
I thought we were going to be like in a room alone and, you know, be myself.
You and Steve kicking it, glass of wine.
Yeah, right, exactly.
Just chit-chatting.
Just talking about boys.
Yeah. No, just one boy.
Okay. All right, studio audience. It's time for your vote. Go ahead and click on the green question mark.
Wait, did
and...
Bruce? What about
I
Bruce?
Want to hear about Bruce.
Oh, that's right. I'm so sorry. I hit a wrong button. Wait.
Oh, man. I'm chopped liver over here. That's how it is.
I'm totally
or some other unsavory food.
God,
you see this, America?
I was so enamored with Vivian. Lost track of all the feedback.
My goodness. Okay.
Vivian. I have to sit next to this man every day.
Yeah. I'm messing up your desk right now. No. So this is what's happening. Vivian, well done. That was very conversational. I love the conversational nature. Letting your guest shine is very important. Letting them take the stage, keeping it comfortable, keeping it conversational. That's what I really liked. And hey, like when you're in there, you can boost up. You're on stage. You're taking it. You know, get that confidence up. But you could do it. Yeah, that's what I'm talking about. Yeah, do a little dance. You know, push our shoulders off. See, I'm Vivian the Conqueror, you know, hearing the lamentation of all the boys. So that's what I'm talking about. Okay. Proceed.
Okay, we ended with a really great pep talk for you. Now, studio audience, no kidding, it's your turn. Go ahead and let's give a vote. Should we choose Vivian tonight? Thank you so much, Vivian, and good luck.
But, hi. If you guys can stop jiggling from the camera, that'd be great.
All right. Just, John, let's try to open a portal over there.
All right.
And we're
going
to go to another cafe that has a really cool special effect as well.
Problem is I can barely see the camera. It's in the whole town.
Hey, I like your, I like...
Yeah, I'm going to go straight to the bar. All right. Over here, as you're loading. So this is Cafe Noir, right?
It's even more a thing.
And this is all black and white. And as you see, we become black and white. It's very Pleasantville-esque. So all I can think about is like World of Dance when they did this whole black and white thing as well. But again, it's like a real restaurant. It's not just like a picture. You can sit at the chairs. You can interact with the environment. You can pretend that you're from, I don't know, the 40s when things were really black and white, right? They were black
Merry
and white.
Merry Christmas, you filthy animal.
So, color was invented by the Nazis, and we have thankfully managed to incorporate their tech into our daily lives.
Yeah, yeah. Exactly. But I mean, this is just a throwback to what life was like back when.
I feel like a child in this room.
Anyway.
All bright and white.
All right. Let's go over here.
You're not that tall.
Here's just a random...
You're not that short.
I'm very tiny.
I'm 6'5", according to Unity, so this room is pretty tiny.
But again, if you change into, you know, all your colorful avatars, I don't think these have a bloom to them or anything, but this has, like, an outline to it, so that looks really...
You want a cup of whatever this is?
Hi, Sarah.
She actually disappears as soon as you pick her.
She's doing her show.
I have to still upload her.
All right, let's get ready for the next room. We're going to have just John open up a portal to the sword art room. And, oh my god, okay. I can't deal with the zombie. Like, I'm, like, hyperventilating. I have asthma. I'm going to need to pause while we go through the portal.
Just to explain, we tortured Vivian this morning with a lot of Pennywise.
How do
so...
I get on the other side of this?
I can't. No, it's not.
Just walk through it.
It's unfair. You know? All right, well, this is what we're going to do. The room that we're going to go into is really small. So we're going to have me, just John, and Ghoster go in, and then you guys follow, okay? So we're just going to open it up.
How do you get up there?
We just got here. So
okay, go.
And then they send you on quests, like, go make a potion for me, and then, you know, go and defeat a stag. Is that correct?
Yeah. Mm-hmm. I mean, Matthew, you want to just give, like, the general overview of what, like, an MMO is? Just in case people watching who don't know.
Just in case my friends are watching.
I would say an MMO is like it's a game. The main element is that it's a game where you do quests and stuff, but it has a singular world or different servers, but a single world with many, many people participating in it. So there's a lot of social stuff. There's a lot of playing together, playing against each other, but also playing, you know, defeating bosses and stuff together. So
So, like, eventually, one of the things that's most popular in most MMOs is eventually, like, running dungeons. So that's where you essentially get a group of, like, five people together. You go and do, like, a specific hard challenge where you might defeat two or three bosses and go, like, deep down into a cave, or we have one that's, like, an old mad wizard's lair and that kind of thing. But yeah, it's really about like learning the game mechanics obviously is important, and you can't really play the game if you don't know the mechanics. But once you get those down, it's really about working with other players to accomplish, you know, to overcome challenges and have fun while you're doing it. So, and we're really excited to be bringing that format to VR. You know, that's something that was not really been done yet. And, you know, as people who love playing MMO games and traditional, you know, 2D PC gaming, that, you know, that's really something that we're passionate about is kind of bringing that into VR in a way that takes
advantage. Yeah, it really adds a bigger social element to it, because people are really next to you and you can really, like the other day I was just having fun traveling with a few people that I hadn't met before, and the sense of community is way higher than it usually is in a game like that, because you're just, you know, you're traveling together and you're hanging out, you're having fun, and it's making friends. It's
oh yeah,
great,
that's true. I'm gonna shout out to Shogu, who is a YouTuber who joined in, but then he quickly saw how bad I was, so he went fishing. Okay, so he'd rather go fishing, okay, than help me beat the guys with the
fishing is very relaxing.
I was gonna say, to be fair, fishing is very fun. So it might not be, you know, you might just flip that around. He just really likes.
You might enjoy it. No, that was
the issue. I wanted to go fishing, and I was like,
oh,
jealous. But like, he chose to do that and not help me get to the fishing part. And anyway, maybe next time. well, that's the thing about this game, though, is that it's the first. So once, what's your history with VR, and like, what made you? Were you racing against the clock, or any competitors be like, we got to be the first ones? Or let's hear a little history about that.
Yeah, so I guess just a little history about like me in particular. Prior to this project, the last thing that I worked on was co-founding an online gaming platform called Roll20, which lets you play Dungeons and Dragons and Pathfinder and like tabletop games over your web browser. That was what I did before this. And after, like, I've been doing that for a few years, and I was kind of ready for my next, you know, start something new. And I had just gotten my VR headset, like, I had gotten an HTC Vive, and I, like, the first time I put it on, I just did some of the games that it came with back then, and I was just, like, blown away by how cool VR was. And I, like, the motion controllers and the whole thing, it just really, I was like, wow, this is amazing. I've got to get involved in this somehow. And so I started doing just some tech demos that I threw up on YouTube with like the rune casting, like if you've seen the videos of the game where you draw spells to cast them. And that got some positive feedback. And I told myself, I'm not going to make an MMO because that's like crazy. You know, like I was like, that's going to be so hard.
It's
I'm not going to do it. It's very ambitious. I'm like, I'm just going to make a single player fantasy game. But then the more I started working on it, the more I was like, you know, this really needs to be an MMO. That's kind of how it came about, was really just me, I guess, loving VR. And then I started assembling a team, obviously, which now we have like 7 or 8 people that work on the game with me, and, you know, they're all great. I think that's kind of the story behind it. You know, there are other people that I've seen working on, you know, VR MMOs, and I'm sure that eventually like a AAA studio will hopefully, you know, put one out, long-term, but, you know, I wouldn't say we're racing against anybody else. I would say we're doing our thing. I'm making the game, and we're making the game we think is cool. And, you know, we're just hoping there's an audience out there that appreciates it like we do and wants to, you know, get involved and enjoy it. So.
And so far, people have been really, really enjoying it and really positive about it, which has been awesome.
Yeah, So I went to your Discord a while back to get to know the community, and they're actually, everyone was really nice, which always surprises me, because I make really bad first impressions, second impressions, third impressions, and I was saying really bad things and just wrong, and they were really nice and welcoming, so I relaxed a little bit. You know, everyone intimidates me, so I was...
They've seen worse, don't worry.
Oh, okay, good. All right. You know, maybe I should try this MMO thing. You know, maybe I fit in better. No? Maybe.
Yeah.
All right.
Yeah.
But we do have a great community, though, and one of the things that I'm really passionate about, and I did with Roll20, and I feel like we're doing a good job with this game, too, is really building it with the community. You know, one of the there's disadvantages to like playing an indie MMO, right? Like, you know, the development team size has to be smaller and the scope has to be smaller and that kind of stuff. But the main advantage, I think, is that, you know, a passionate development team can really work with the community to make something that's like amazing and was better than we would have come up on our own. And if you go visit our Discord or our forums, you know, you'll see that we're in there every day. every hour, you know, talking to the community about how to make the game better. And, you know, we're really passionate about that. So,
yeah, I think someone got mad because they're like, how did Riley have time to do your show? He's on a deadline. So they're holding you accountable. So, you know, but I want to talk more about the community because we're all about community building here. Sure. But first, you know, I've made it known that VR developers, I feel like they should, there's a market out there for them, and that's me, just me alone. I will buy all the things. I really like, you know, cutesy things. Like, why can't we have more games with, like, ponies and, you know, like, anyway, so the point is I love your color scheme, purple, pink, and then before I knew that those guys were going to try and kill me, they were really cute. So, and, oh, and there's a pet dragon that,
I was
like,
say the dragon, that's your
yeah,
dragon.
Yeah,
there we go. I'm kind of sitting on the back. Okay, this is good. This is good. I'm running Vivian whenever you are.
Okay. Well, that was fun. Well, let's just get down to some of the questions I have, just in case you disappear again. There he goes. That's okay. You know what? I'll just stand. That way you can stand.
Me too.
That's right. Okay. You're cool. Fine. So anyway, I'm actually not a big fan of post-apocalyptic zombie type things, but I did read The Walking Dead as it came out because it had such good characters, and it really wasn't about the zombies. You know, it was really about the characters and the people.
Exactly.
So, and your novels, you know, are like an extension of that.
Yeah.
So,
yeah.
Can you talk about like what you chose to write about, and you know, like what?
Well, that's it. That's it exactly. Like you can write a novel. It's much harder to write a novel like that would be a take on like say Night of the Living Dead. Because it's just raw, you know, experience and everything. But the Walking Dead goes much further inside the characters internally. And that's what novels are. Novels are internal, you know. They're internal for the reader, and they're internal for the characters that are in them. You go inside the characters, you know, and the scares, the shock scenes in a novel or internal, like your mind, you know, imagines, it's more interactive. You're just suggesting sensory detail to the human imagination, and then it's creating. That's one of the myriad reasons why people go, I love the book, I didn't really like the movie. Because, you know, movies are
right,
just,
exactly.
Yeah.
You know, sort of specific, you know, they're just like someone's conception of what everything looks like, and it's a pale thing, you know, compared to what your imagination, you know, can create.
So I was gonna say that I'm actually a writer as well, and I write, you know, fiction.
Cool.
And one of the things about writing is like they always say you have to be like, it's a very vulnerable thing because you're taking something in your head, and people, first of all, you have to be entertaining. You have to entertain people. And then they get to know what kind of things go through your head. And since you write horror, have you had any like experiences with that? Yeah. I mean, because it is definitely one thing, like when you write suspense or thrillers, it's like, all right, people are going to know how I would dispose of a body or, you know, okay. You talk a little bit about that, because I know you have a lot.
Well, I think when you're a little child, very young, you start to learn, even when you're maybe 4 or 5 years old, you start to learn that there's a difference between fantasy and reality. And like some people have a harder time processing that. But some people are really good at processing it really young, at a young age, you know. So, like, you know, you can, I you know, the people that get really dark on the page, like in the 80s, there was this movement in horror called splatterpunk. And those people got as dark as I could possibly imagine. I mean, they pushed the envelope of darkness and of gore. And out of that movement came geniuses like Clive Barker and Edward Lee. But the thing is, they are among the people, the population, who like learns early what the difference between fantasy and you know, reality is. And some people never learn, you know, some people end up, you know, really struggling with it. And your body doesn't really know the difference. You know, you, when you're scared from a novel or a movie, your body doesn't know that it's fantasy, you know. But when you make it up, when you make it up for a living, you're processing something completely different. You know, you're processing your own subconscious. So you're right. I mean, there is a connection, and anybody that denies it in the horror field is lying. You know, there's totally a connection to the subconscious and stories. I don't think I'm a weird person though because of it. I know you weren't implying that, but like my wife called me up one time. She was traveling and she was reading one of the Walking Dead books, and she's like, "Hi, just finished Fall of the Governor Part 2, or it was Part 1, Fall of the Governor Part 1. You know the rape scene toward the end? Was that your idea, or was that Kirkman?" And I'm like, "You can relax." Honey, that was Kirkman. I just translated it into prose.
Yeah. Just blame everything on Kirkman.
I do. And even Robert Kirkman has said that, you know, he'll write something in a comic book script, and then he'll see it, like an artist will render it, and he'll go, "Oh my God, that's disgusting," you know, and they go, "Well, yeah, but you kind of came up with the idea." And he goes, "Yeah, but I didn't know it was going to look that disgusting, you know." And they're like, "Well, you shouldn't have come up with the idea then if you didn't want to see it." But even Robert Kirkman gets grossed out by the stuff sometimes.
Well, it does. It is good. It is pretty scary. I for sure think I have a plan, but I would probably just, you know, be one of them to fit in. So, but, you know, I'm sure you get asked all the time, do you have an escape plan? Do you have a like a zombie survival kit or ideas of what you would do?
I would totally die within like 5 minutes of the zombie. I'm such a wimp.
All right, you need to get it.
In fact, I'm not feeling really that well right now. I think this may kill me.
Well, good. Right.
Well, I don't know about you two, but I at least plan to be patient zero. That's the best way to do it.
Yeah, that's a good strategy.
Knowing John, it was probably his fault. So. The zombies came.
I think that if I was in a real zombie apocalypse, I would try to be like that character in the Winnebago. Like he sat on top of his Winnebago and had a little cooler with beer in it, and you know, a radio, battery operated radio, and you know, a little lawn chair, and he just like got drunk and just let the world pass him by, and he was on top of, much like we are right now on top of this truck. I mean, that's his name is Dale. He got eaten, of course, like everybody does. But anyway.
Of course, yeah, he got eaten, of course. See, that's what happens when you work with zombies. You're just like, yeah. I mean, like, I feel the same way about Game of Thrones. Like, you can't get attached to characters, you know?
Right.
The same way with The Walking Dead, which is a very real thing, because it used to be the rule is you can't kill main characters, right? But nowadays,
that's what
like...
makes and that's part of its popularity. Like everybody's at risk, anything could happen, even the most beloved characters. Like I'm not going to spoil
remember.
It if you haven't seen it, but
if you haven't you seen
know,
it, what's wrong with
the
you?
Most beloved
I know exactly
characters
what you're talking
bite
about.
The dust.
This is so romantic. This is a perfect place to go on a date because you can go to stores and go shopping, which happens to be my favorite thing to do anyway.
You just like people to spend money on you. The homepage for this should not be so dark because I wanted to go into it. It looked a little dark, but now that I'm in here, wow, this is really, really cool.
Yeah, so this is the first in a series of experiences at Creator Academy. So what we're trying to do here, because we are about user-created content, trying to show off what you can do, how to leverage the different materials that are within the Sansar system, the rendering materials.
Why does the physics engine suck so bad? I mean, your avatars are terrible.
I am a beholder, I suppose. And like I said, we're in beta, so we are working on it. And avatars, what you know, the physics? How,
yeah, look at, look at how your hands are moving. It looks so fake. And yeah, look at the avatars on even high fidelity or VR chat. It's literally half of what VR chat does.
this is very interesting because we're actually streaming this live. So
I'm sorry.
Yeah, it's okay. because your avatar actually looks appropriate for you.
So I think to address your feedback, you will see a big jump forward.
But it's also from Linden Lab, right? Linden Lab is like known for running some sleazy ass stuff, like the furry stuff and all that.
Wow, kind of Jason, we did not plant this person.
Yeah, no, hey, you know, this is it's a social platform. Everyone can come in and share their thoughts and their feedback, and just
get some Lindens. Get some Lindens and buy some garbage over here. Buy your fake costume jewelry for your fake life.
Well, it's great. What I wanted to show you here, though, is there's so many, you can see all the different...
And then some private client work, which was good. And then, yeah, so we've changed a lot over the years.
Oh. Well, that was strange. A lot of people just fell through. I apologize. I don't. That's so weird.
Fell through.
That's like such poor hostessing. I'm sorry about that.
Yeah.
Weird things that can happen in this VR.
That's okay.
I know, right?
That was boring.
Yeah.
That was boring.
No. It's so strange. It's, you know what? It's like this is a user created space and room, which is kind of like. The cool thing, you know, because like in Facebook spaces, it's like you have like you can change the scenery, but you're pretty like set there. So that's kind of the special thing about that and like you can have like an audience here with you.
I love that.
Yeah, which is really cool too. And there's other people in other rooms. So if you see little circles and you know emojis coming out, they're in other rooms.
Uh-huh.
And yeah, so if you have a question, you can look on your bottom right and you can ask us a question as well. So you know, before you worked in VR, you were in fashion, right? And
yes.
I see that like okay, well, first of all, you are a part of or you co-founded right the AR VR women's group, which is awesome because I guess with like for me at my current job, I work with a lot of women. It's, you know, a woman CEO, you know, half the team on our executive team is women. So I'm used to it. And then of course I come in work in tech and it's, you know, not a huge representation. So it's really awesome for me to see a lot of you guys on there. So how did that start?
How did that start? That started in 2015. My co-founder, Jody Schiller, who is no longer a part of the group, we've co-founded it and we just saw that there was really a need to bring women together, especially like in an emerging sector, like right away, because then we have the ability to bring in more women and make it friendly for women to come in. So we started having meetups regularly and having job fairs, things like that in San Francisco. And then the Facebook group started, and then we had an education series at the time. And then the educators got scooped up by other VR companies, so we stopped doing that. And it's just grown a lot.
Saying so, there is a trophy to be won, guys. This is for this is for a big prize. We will reveal that afterwards. It may be a corner office. It may be half-eaten food. We will see. So we will start the game. I am too short for this.
I'm so excited.
Question.
I want to, yes.
Are there any rules like rhymes like, you know, can't say rhymes like can't say.
I feel like that's such a cheap shot. You should know that.
I know that, but I just want to make sure that, you know, like Steven over there knows that.
Yeah, watch him. Okay. Yeah, you guys can't say rhymes with Lindos, okay?
So, usual charade.
Findos?
Findos. Findos or Shindos. No rhyming. You can't, there's no rhyming. And try not to say the word. If you say the word, that doesn't count. Anyway, isn't this, first of all, can't you say how cool this is?
This is awesome. This is awesome. This is who, this is why we made this space. Okay. This is exactly why we made it.
Don't let Phil take credit. You know who did this? Jacob made this.
I was about to say,
Jacob.
The space maker.
In one day, so it's quite amazing.
Phil gets the initial credit.
Jacob, the space maker.
Well, I mean, the idea of the event space is what I meant. So thank you for leveraging the event space and building on top of it.
Weeks and months, and so there was a lot of work that we needed.
Jimmy, you're breaking it. Stop.
Jimmy. Okay, magical. there is a rule though. Guys. This is a VR technical rule. Only one of you guys can pick up the card at once. Okay, so see in front of you, you have the blue pile and the red pile. All right, so you're gonna pick up from the blue pile. That's gonna be your card, and you're gonna discard it in the red pile. All right, and then so you guys are going to play three rounds. So the first round is going to be Phil. In 1 minute, you're going to get Schmidtek and Jimmy to legally guess all of your words. And then we're going to ping it over here to Lynn back and forth until you're done. And then we're going to have a lightning round. A winner takes all for the really cool prize that we have. Absolutely, yes. Oh, no. When it comes to that,
but
there's no rules.
Oh, oh, she's intimidating me.
No VR bullying. Come on.
So we should probably have hands, huh?
You should.
Yeah, he doesn't have hands. Steven doesn't have hands.
Well, it's interesting. Okay. I'm holding my touches.
Hands are
but
optional.
Not
you might want a brain. That's really all that matters. So let's.
I could while away the hour, conferring with the flowers.
This card,
how about some emojis from our game master in the back there for when you're ready and I can. You're not the game master.
And everyone else.
everybody else.
Follow directions.
How do I get the cards back, Vivian? I'm sorry. This is the best. Miss Hoover, I ate my cards.
How do I get the cards back? Press the red button. Isn't that funny? Look at the word. Look at the word.
Got it.
Yes, oh, nice. Come on. You can't plan that. Go ahead and click the red one. I'm kind of going low everywhere because I'm wearing heels.
What?
Dancing on tables?
Not yet.
She was a cheerleader for 15
years. I didn't have touch. Facts. Back in the old office, I was on the Oculus little remote, so I'm still getting used to these hands.
So. And
maybe,
computers and
Keegan,
the internet.
Will you go first on our team?
We got it.
All right, thanks.
Okay, Keegan's really nice. All right.
Because now I have like three hands, and I'm not sure which why.
Yeah. Right. Wait. First of all, Lynn.
Yeah.
What are you on one of the new Windows systems? Just tell us now. We need to know.
No, Windows systems works seamlessly and
seamlessly.
You don't ever have trouble with your hands.
Yes.
Brought to you by, that was our commercial break. Okay.
Black Friday. Okay. All right. So Keegan.
Oh, my batteries are dying. That's why. All right. Keegan's going first.
All right. I thought Phil was going first.
We can defer back to you. I'll Rochambeau for it.
Okay. I'm ready. I got one.
Oh my gosh.
Okay. Who's first? That's so rude in VR. Come on. Actually, did you guys know that the pizza burp, when you go to the house party and you eat the pizza, when it burps, it's my burp. It was recorded. I'm very proud.
T-I-L.
Wow.
Anyways, okay. Are you ready, guys?
Yeah.
Let's do it.
Okay, so just
time,
okay,
timer
so
this, ready?
Wait, is the timer ready?
Timer's going off.
Timer?
It's going.
It's going. Okay, guys, we have a lot of these. It's like all over the office, and there's like...
Wires.
We
Oculus.
We work on a lot of these.
Computers. Windows, monitors.
No.
Steven, help me out.
We're cross what? We're cross what on a lot of
platforms.
Platforms, guys. What platforms are we on?
Vive, Rift.
Vive.
Gear VR, Android,
Gear,
phone.
Gear VR.
Fuck, she got it.
Did we win?
No. Keep going.
One more.
Wait, do I keep going?
Oh, keep going, keep going, keep going, keep going, keep going. Okay. Keep going.
Okay. Wait, oh, discard. I'm discarding. Oh, God. Wait, what's another platform we're on?
Vive, Rift, Gear VR, Oculus. Android, Daydream.
Yeah, Gear VR.
Oh, my
God.
That was terrible.
I keep a pile of things
Time's up.
I want to keep going.
Ding.
Oh.
All right, we got two.
We got two. Wow. Trying to beat that, y'all.
That was two.
So bad.
Nice job.
Not one of your points over here.
They got two, I think.
You don't get one of our points.
How did that happen?
Okay, all right. We'll get you one, right? So two.
I'm still trying to get rid of this card.
You guys, this is once in a lifetime to watch.
We got two of them. Come on.
Yeah, the score right, please, before we.
I'll think about it.
We're good.
Well, let's start over here. Bill.
Deep breath.
Bill,
all right. Okay.
Are you ready? Let's wait for the timer.
All right.
I'm ready.
Ready?
Wait,
I'm ready.
The timer.
Okay.
Ready?
You tell me.
There we go. Go.
Okay, so if you are, it's a type of genre for a game.
First person shooter.
It's like kind of when you like explore and stuff, and you do
sandbox.
Fun stuff. Okay, let's say I want to go on a fun exploration of some sort, and
RPG.
Okay, it's a theme park, okay.
Massively multiplayer online role-playing.
Okay, it's, all right.
Vengeance is ours.
Okay.
Oh my god.
Okay, it's like, if you're gonna just go on a fun expedition, I'm going on a fun...
Exploration.
Yeah, but it's not that, but, like, you know, if I'm gonna embark on a new journey, it is what? Like, I'm embarking on a new...
Quest?
Like, yeah, but it's more like, okay.
You guys are going to hate yourself.
Somebody did worse than us.
All right, you know what? This
it's point time.
Points for entertainment, guys.
Wow.
Okay.
What was it?
Right. Oh,
it's an
well,
adventure.
That was good,
adventure.
You guys.
Didn't you say adventure? Didn't you say adventure? I thought you said adventure.
I said a lot of different things. So.
Wait, well, we'll have to take this. All
right,
back
hold on.
Afterwards.
Can we just make a rule where we have like the other team is not distracting us, because that is just like really hard to do.
We didn't say anything.
It rhymes with
adventure. Oh, okay. All right. Oh, it's on like Donkey Kong now. Then all right, let's go see you next.
Let's do it.
Hey, leave our cards alone.
All right, let's see how this is gonna work without hands.
Okay. All right, we're having Steven next. Steven.
Oh my god.
Just
are
assume...
you ready,
Steven?
Let's
we
find
have
out.
We have a timer ready.
Ah, there we go. Right.
Timer.
Okay, so the TP Link is an accessory for the Vive. It makes the Vive what?
What?
Okay, that's what
it's a great description, but you gotta know your audience, Steven.
Okay, so it's another word for the cable that comes out of the headset. What is it?
A cord?
Cable.
Close. It's also part of a
connector.
Sport. Blank ball.
Connector.
Transposter.
Football.
Think
ball.
Cable?
Ball.
Rope?
Cable TV.
Rope.
Nope.
Adventure. Just keep saying.
So if you were skydiving, this is something
falling.
That's attached that attaches
red,
you
red
to
cord.
The other guy.
Cord. Nope.
Tandem.
That is true.
Oh, that's so close. What?
Coax. Coax cable.
I can't believe.
Come on, Steven, give us something
wow.
else.
One.
It was tether.
Tether ball.
That was a good one.
Tether ball. Damn, that's a good description.
Okay, you guys.
Yeah,
first
one.
Of all,
I came up with like three things.
I just have to say
nice
something.
Nice job.
Our executive producer Shannon came up with 90 words, and I said, "You need more words." I think we've gone through four words. So I'm gonna go ahead and give you guys a handicap that we honestly thought would have been a hindrance. But we're gonna go ahead and
you know, that was the warm-up round. I think we're I think we're okay now.
Sure. Okay, here's your handicap. You may pass.
Yay! Hey!
Okay.
Wait, so on a pass you get a negative point?
Okay, no, you just don't get a point. You just don't
Okay.
There's gotta be a maximum.
Actually,
no. Well, hang on. Give them one more round without it, and then we can start.
I might have to defer. I don't have hands, so I don't know what the power. I don't know what the power word is.
All you have to do is click on them. Click on blue. Click on red. You don't need hands.
Steven, I'm just saying, in the camera.
Unfortunately, I'm just saying black cards for everything, and I'm clicking. It's not doing.
You have to get up close to it.
Maybe I'll.
Well, you could also go. You could go on that side too and read what's on this side over here, right?
Oh, okay, that's a good idea.
That's a good idea.
I don't know. Okay, so I don't know. Somebody has to flick it to the next one though, because I can't flick it to the next one.
Oh, that's true. And then we have to promise not to look at it.
Yeah. Okay.
All right. Ready, team zero. All right,
come on, Jimmy.
Let's do this.
High five. Let's do it.
You already said this one. Let's get the camera out here.
Okay. All right.
M&Ms.
So in
The timer.
All right.
There we go. Go.
Sorry.
It's going.
Yep.
Immersion.
Okay. And this is a really good word for virtual reality where everybody is in thing doing something.
In world social VR.
Let's see. It's like in Ready Player One, they all go into the
Oasis. Metaverse.
Metaverse. Ding 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 ding.
Okay. All right. Cool, next.
Go. All right. A Gear VR. HTC
headset, Vive. HMD, HMD Oculus, headset, virtual reality headset.
These are all on what different types of?
Platform.
Okay. All right, cool. So when you used to go to the arcade and play things, you go to the arcade to play?
Games, video games.
Video games!
Oh my gosh.
Keep going.
And there's a social media platform that everybody in the world is on.
Facebook.
Next.
Okay, keep going.
And why didn't I get that one?
You go into your car to go somewhere and you
drive.
That's the buzzer.
Traveling. Oh, yeah.
Nice.
On the board, baby.
Well done.
On the board.
Yeah.
On the board.
I'm not even mad. That was amazing.
Let's get a lot of emojis because Lynn is next, guys. Lynn is next.
No! I'm having trouble with my hands. Can I choose a surrogate from the audience to flip my cards?
No, I'll flip the card for you.
But you got it.
One.
Okay.
Only three players to a team, please. Only three players to a team.
Yeah.
Here and read it.
Okay, wait. I needed new batteries, and I should have checked that before, so I did not. Okay.
Batteries not required for reading. Let's go.
Let's get the timer up.
All right, team, are you ready?
Yeah, go.
Go. I'm not.
You're looking the wrong way.
You don't see it?
No.
It's
in front of the.
In front of
right there.
No, it's not.
What?
Oh, that?
Yellow
light. Oh,
yeah.
We start the timer over.
Okay, guys. She just learned the internet. Let's restart that.
I thought that was somebody's. Okay, is it starting? Okay, this is my email.
We need to give her
address.
Yes.
Email.
He got it. Address. Next. Oh, the initials for this thing that is on our head is three letters.
HTC?
No, but it's...
HMD.
I don't know if that
counts.
Got it. Okay. It's informational, but it's also...
Data.
When you take a class, it's informational, but it's also...
Educational.
We got to give it 30 more
educational.
Seconds.
Come on. Got it.
You put the timer back up.
Oh.
You got it.
Okay, keep going.
Next.
We still got 30
one.
Seconds.
Oh gosh, when I'm looking out this glass square thing that Microsoft made a lot
monitor?
Of money off of.
Window.
She got it.
Yeah,
window.
Got it.
Okay. Window. Oh, the guy who started Microsoft. Who started Microsoft? Bill Gates, thank you. And we are all now this of Microsoft. FTEs or an?
Employees?
Yes.
Wow.
And this is a candy that is round and chocolate and has a little tiny leather on it.
M&M's.
Yes, that's the time.
All right. You know, some of those were a little questionable, but we'll give it to you.
Questionable.
Yeah. Yeah. Didn't say there's three letters.
Yeah. This is not, what was that game, Phil, that you're saying? This is not Juno or whatever. Phil knows Juno every game ever made.
A love
what did
taboo.
You say this? Taboo.
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 Got it. All no, right. What's I'm saying?
Taboo the movie.
A little suspect, but. All right. That's all right.
I'm feeling
Jimmy,
a little hostility here. I'm feeling a little hostility. So
I thought this was supposed to. I thought this was game was supposed to launch us as a team up to Redmond.
No, oh, yes.
No.
Yeah,
no.
Well, you found out that we get pretty competitive. So
yes.
And all this time, you guys, we're trying to help you, alt space people. Come on. This is how you need to behave with your new peoples. Up in Washington.
Well, they have no idea what's coming.
Well, now it's going to be on YouTube so they can watch it. Well,
well they've been
do.
Hearing me shout at them for the last half hour, so I think they're getting some idea of what they're in it for.
Oh, oh that's
good.
True.
Steven's a team player.
He's
all right.
Lemon.
Because Phil and Keegan are sitting really close to each other, I want to make it as uncomfortable as possible. So what we're going to do is we are going to let them do one more regular round, okay? Okay, for 1 point each in 1 minute. So Phil versus Keegan, okay? So Phil, you're going to start off, and this time you can pass. Are you
okay.
ready?
I'm ready.
All right, start the time. Go.
Okay, so this is one of our HMDs. It's on the PC. It's not Oculus Rift.
HTC Vive.
HTC Vive.
Okay. Yep. So this is. So you are a blank engineer.
Software.
Okay. This is the app that we built. The name of it.
Oculus VR.
Okay. So in Silicon Valley, there are many types of this company.
Startups.
Well, it's like, it's not healthcare, it's not healthcare, it's not, so we are like electronics, software, this is all, what's the full word for that?
Technology.
Technology.
Okay. Yep. So the, New York, wait, no.
Knicks.
Oh, no.
Knickerbockers.
Yeah,
pizza. Sports pizza.
hold on. Okay. The New York stock.
Exchange.
Okay. Yep. Oh, good clue.
Okay, there are three types of categories in AltSpace.
Wait. The timer's already out, I think.
Sorry, Phil. He didn't hear
it.
He was
so into it.
He was so into it. He was in the zone.
I was just
yeah.
like, you know.
Definitely.
That adrenaline.
Keegan, are you ready?
All right.
I'm ready. Ready, guys?
This is our chair.
All right.
I'm ready. Let's do it.
All right, again. Microsoft, the symbol that you look through.
Window.
Yep.
Clippy.
For HTC, these are on the ceilings to be able to read where your head
lighthouse.
Is, where your
tracker
sensor.
No, but more
sensor.
Yeah.
What is the company we work for?
Microsoft.
AltSpace.
AltSpace.
Oh, Microsoft.
Changed.
If you don't take an Uber, you take a
Lyft.
Lyft.
A cab.
Oh, damn, good one.
Yeah, you spelled it wrong.
you can use Google Docs, or you can do this on the Microsoft platform that is called
Excel.
SharePoint.
Word. Word.
If I do this and I play other things on HTC Vive and Rift, I am playing
PC?
What?
Video games?
Yes, but
you're a gamer.
No,
okay,
that
good
one.
Video game?
Wow, well done, Keegan. I gotta give you some emojis for that. Good job.
Oh,
wow.
The next one was good, too.
What was it?
Yeah.
They're coming together. Do you see this? There's like friendships forming, I feel like. That was not the attention I was going for.
Oh
I was
God,
looking
we're behind,
for some.
Guys. We're behind.
All right, uh-oh. But that didn't happen. Okay, so we have 11
Who
over
won?
Here for the Lins. And we have 9 over here for the over-aggressive players.
Totally.
The name of the team, the Warriors. So
yeah, we're going to do a lightning round. And you have to pick Steven or Lynn from over here, or Jimmy or Schmidtek.
They went first. We get it one more round, right?
No, you went first.
No, they did go
first.
Yeah, they went first. Yeah.
Check the tape.
We get one more round, right?
No. We're gonna end this now, okay?
Oh my god.
No. Finish it.
We're getting short shrift.
Oh my gosh. Wow. Jimmy, you know I am just down the hallway.
Give him another round. We're gonna have a
okay. It's like that time when something wasn't fair.
Okay.
If you think it's not fair, give me a heart.
Wait, Jimmy, the game isn't over.
There we go.
That's just peer pressure.
That's just pity. Don't listen to them. Okay. Yeah. Okay, this is what we're gonna do, okay? We're gonna have Jimmy. I'm just gonna pick Jimmy versus Lynn for the lightning round. All right. It's gonna be worth 2 points each for the words. Ooh. Are you ready for 1 minute?
All right, come on, Jimmy.
Wait, what am I doing? Guessing?
Oh no.
Jimmy versus me, maybe?
Just read the card.
I don't know.
No, but this is how we're gonna start it. Because the Lynns are up, we're gonna let them go first. Okay, and then we're gonna allow the passive aggressive people to go after, see if they can catch up. So we're gonna do the Lynns first. Lynn, and you wanna go stand up here and read the words again, and I will go ahead and click it for you. You have one minute.
You have 1 minute to win it.
Oh my god.
Exactly.
Okay.
Go.
Wait, it just changed. We are working inside of a
virtual reality?
No, no. Oh, actually, the real thing, a structure with walls is a
building?
Oh.
Yeah.
A space
and like when you say goodbye from your show or you log.
Sign off.
Yes. When I drive my car to Microsoft, I pull into a
parking garage?
But the actual individual
space. Parking space.
Yes. Parking space, yes. This thing on my noggin is a
headset.
Thank you. And oh my god, are you kidding me? Pass.
Our first pass. Fine. Our first pass.
The kind of computer that lets you play something.
A gaming PC.
Oh, you're awesome.
Oh, that's so specific.
And a spreadsheet, the brand of spreadsheet. Thank you.
Time's up.
No more.
Double points.
Well, nice.
Well done. That was hard. Team. You guys got good guessing.
You nailed it.
Man. Yeah. That
was good.
We got hard
ones. For those guys.
Yeah.
Thank you.
You got to give it up for team gaming PC.
Okay. Are we?
Oh yeah.
That's a good one.
That would have been better. I was thinking Nutrisystem.
Jimmy, are you ready? Wait, we gotta reset the clock here. We got a little overzealous.
You ready?
Wait. Oops. Wait.
Let me know. Oh.
Nope.
We gotta reset.
We got the.
Gotta wait. Gone over there.
Or we could just sit here for 1 minute and contemplate our life.
No, don't do that.
There's a short one already.
Yeah. Okay. Can we reset the clock? No. You know what? We'll just wait. Why not? Oh. What do you guys think of the show?
Star.
This is awesome.
I think it's going pretty awesome so far. Absolutely.
So far, it's.
I hope it's just as entertaining for the audience as it is for us, because I'm having a blast at least. Great. It could be totally boring.
This is something
to watch.
That I never knew that I've always wanted to do.
Yeah. All right. I think
don't
we
want
have
this
a,
to end.
We have an activity to happen, so.
Like this is always fun.
Okay. Well, 5 seconds of pleasantries, guys. How about some more compliments? Oh.
Well done, team over there. Good job over there.
Nice. All right. That's over. That's done. Let's
compliments after the game.
Let's do this.
Oh, okay.
Ready? Ready? All right. And the clock, go.
Not Facebook, but
MySpace,
Instagram, Twitter.
Twitter.
Wow. on the table that you're working on, there is a
keyboard
thing that gives you light. The thing that gives you light.
The lap, desktop,
monitor.
Is that good?
Desk,
sure.
Lamp,
keyboard with LCDs.
Go away. Samsung's
Gear VR.
Yeah. Yep. The thing that's really expensive when you buy your computer.
Go GPU.
Video card.
GPU. Graphics card. Graphics processor.
Wow.
Not
nice.
Twitter, but Mark Zuckerberg's company.
Facebook. Facebook.
Come on.
Because he keeps
the thing. The display for your computer is also called a
monitor.
Yep. Monitor.
Oh and my Windows gosh. Creates a
operating system.
Yep.
Oh my gosh.
What?
You know what?
Sudden death.
That was a tie, and I.
We both win.
Came back from zero.
We're out of quiz.
Maybe I am. I'm not sure. You know what?
We're number two.
We're tied for second.
We're also number two.
Make you like 1.5 or. All right.
How about we show them the prize that we have for our lovely folks here? If you just hold on to your hats. You guys are going to Washington, so we wanted to give you guys fruits. This is your eye trophy, apple. It's very appropriate for your
That's
move.
Cute.
You can go ahead and display this at your brand That's new cute. Microsoft's office.
That is an apple.
Awesome.
As a welcoming to your new employees.
This is great.
Yeah.
Someone took a bite out of it. Yeah. Thank you for putting this together.
That's very sweet.
Wow.
This is awesome.
I didn't know that could even be a thing. That's amazing.